Hi, I'm Samantha, and I'm going to help you today figure out what's a good shoe and what's a bad shoe. One of the simplest ways of doing this is to use the three-point test. The three-point test I will demonstrate on these two shoes here. Now, this shoe here is going to be our example of a bad shoe. The first thing you want to check is something called forefoot flexibility. So, if you can easily roll your running shoe up into a ball or fold it in half like this, that's not a good thing. When you're running, all the weight is going to go on the ball of your feet. And think about how that's going to feel after a few miles. This is going to be our example of a good shoe. So we still have some flex here, but I can't fold it in half very easily. What happens when you run, you have a nice roll off the ball of your foot. And therefore, the pressure is distributed more evenly, and you don't have that same pressure on the ball of your foot. Back to our bad shoe. The second part is called torsional stability. That means you shouldn't be able to wring your running shoe out. This, bad. Not going to give you any support through the arch where you need it. On the other hand, our good shoe, this is great. All that support through the arch right where you need it. Lastly, and one of the most important of the three, I think, is the heel counter. This should be nice and firm. I shouldn't be able to squish this down. When you run, you need a stable heel counter so that you don't overpronate. You take the good shoe. This is a tank. When you're running in this, your foot's going to be very happy. When you're running in this, you're headed for trouble. So, next time you buy a pair of running shoes, use the three-point test. And to also check the shoes that you're currently wearing. If you can do this, this, or this, it's time to find a new shoe.